This is the Gree mini split air conditioner circuit board that I was repairing in the previous video. The circuit board was completely dead and had a short circuit, which I couldn't initially locate. The issue was with the UVW outdoor fan blower motor drive IC, so I changed it. I've reinstalled all the components that were previously removed. However, the circuit board is still not functioning and turning on. Now, let's try to identify what the issue is. I'll guide you through it so that we can fix the PCB together, and you'll also gain some knowledge about what could be causing the problem. I have already checked the high side, and it's perfectly fine without any issues. However, now we need to check the low side. Today, we'll work on the low side and check all the points there and see why the microcontroller isn't turning on. I'll show you by powering up the circuit board to demonstrate that it's not turning on, and then we can proceed with further testing. I've arranged all the electrical setup here, but first, let me clarify one thing. The small relay is used to check the high circuit side of the PCB, while the big relay is installed to handle the compressor's load. You can't directly turn on this circuit from the high side. It needs to be connected to the indoor circuit for proper communication. Only then will the switching activate, and then it will start functioning. Now, we are connecting the electricity here, and let's see whether it functions or not. I just need to install the reactor along with it. Electricity is now passing through the circuit. We are getting 228 volts on the multimeter. However, this circuit board hasn't turned on, and the light that was supposed to blink isn't blinking. So I'll only check the low side because I've already fixed the high side. So I will now check the low side to see where the voltages aren't correct. In the first phase, I have two options. First, I'll check the entire SMPS to see if it's generating the correct voltages and if those voltages are reaching the microcontroller and wherever else these voltages are needed. The switching IC is numbered TNY278PN, and it is installed here. We'll check all the inputs and outputs to ensure they are coming through properly, since this IPM had a short circuit and got damaged. First, the voltages must be present here, which is necessary for the microcontroller and other components to start. Now, I will perform a complete testing of the circuit board. A good point here is that the company has already marked several test points, so we can easily check the voltages at each point. They have mentioned 3 points, and I will check the IPM from the start. All 3 points are present here, marked for 15 volts, ground, 12 volts, and 5 volts. We should be getting these voltages at these points. If we get the correct voltages here, it means that the issue will likely move on to the next stage. So I've supplied power to the circuit board, so first I'll check the AC voltages. We're getting 215 volts AC here, which is fine. Now I'll check the DC voltages. I am checking the DC voltages on the pins of the rectifier. We're expecting better output. 292 volts are coming through. These voltages are a bit low, but they are sufficient to power the circuit board, meaning they are adequate to activate the low side section. Let's check all these voltages. I will put the black probe of the multimeter on the ground. First of all, I will check the 5 volts. The 5 volts are coming through perfectly. Now, it's time to check the 12-volt line, and as you can see, the 12-volt is also coming through properly. Finally, let's check the 15-volt line. I will check it on this capacitor, and the 15 volts are also present. This means that the switching IC and the SMPS are both functioning correctly. Now, I will check the fan motor drive area, because its intelligent power module had a short circuit and exploded. Let's find out if there is any damage in this area that might be preventing it from working. I suspect that the issue lies here because if the voltages are correct, the system should be functioning. So let's see if there is any short circuit in this area. I've set the multimeter to diode mode, and I will start by checking this diode. The diode is perfectly fine. The multimeter is showing a voltage drop on this diode. This means that it's functioning correctly. This voltage drop value on the diode is showing because I'm checking the diode while it's still on the circuit board. Now, let's check all the capacitors. Set the multimeter to continuity mode. We should hear a beep sound in continuity mode when we attach the probes. Right now, we can use continuity mode to check the capacitors. These capacitors block the DC and filter the AC. Since we are checking it, we should not get a long beep on the capacitors in continuity mode. There was a brief beep sound and then it stopped. This means that the DC has been blocked, which indicates that the capacitor is perfectly fine. We need to check all the capacitors in the same way. I was just sharing this to enhance your knowledge. Now, I will check all the resistors here. This resistor is showing 0.8 ohms, which means it's working correctly. Let's check which one is faulty. We'll check each component one by one. If even one resistor or capacitor is shorted, it will cause problems in the circuit. These capacitors here are for the low in. Let's check here to see if there's a short circuit. A resistor is here, showing a resistance of 470 ohms, which is correct. Now let's check another one. Oh, it's showing 33.74 kilo ohms, which is quite high. Moving on to the next point, it's showing 470 ohms, which is correct. The third one is showing 16 kilo ohms, and the next one is showing 22 kilo ohms. Finally, the last one is showing 40 kilo ohms. This suggests there might be a problem here, so we should also check the capacitors to ensure none of them are shorted or open. If a capacitor is open, it won't cause much of a problem, except that the fan might not work. However, if there is a short circuit, it could lead to more significant issues. There is no continuity in the capacitors, so they aren't shorted. However, the resistances are showing very high resistance values. These three resistors here were burned, each with a value of 470 ohms. I have replaced these three resistors here, and three are not replaced. However, the problem with this circuit persists. I will continue to investigate further and check for additional issues. I'll share the details of this problem with you so that if you encounter a similar issue, you can also understand it. I have this IPM module in my hand, which has short-circuited and exploded. It's pins 7, 8, and 9, and if we check its datasheet, these pins are high input for this driver, which comes from the microcontroller. The same three resistors that burned were connected to these pins, and due to this, a surge of high voltage was sent toward the microcontroller. This surge could have either damaged the microcontroller or caused another component to short-circuit, which is why the circuit is showing multiple short circuits on the low side. Let me demonstrate what I mean. I've set my multimeter to continuity mode. As you can see, I've removed capacitor number 42 from the circuit, and even after removing it, I'm still getting continuity at this point, which is not a good sign. Because on the capacitor's pads, the negative and positive points should have no continuity. This is capacitor number 74. I have removed it from the circuit board, but the continuity issue is still present. The points where we are getting 5 and 12 volts, see, these capacitors have no short circuit. This is a 3.3 volt voltage regulator. And when we move forward from the regulator to this capacitor, and as soon as the probes are attached to the microcontroller's capacitor, the short circuit is present here. Every capacitor I'm checking is shorted. Almost all the capacitors are showing as short circuited. The cause of these capacitors being shorted could be a single faulty component, and the microcontroller may be also shorted. If the microcontroller is shorted, the entire circuit will show a short circuit. As I mentioned earlier, there was a high voltage surge, so there's a good chance that the microcontroller is damaged. Until it's replaced, this circuit won't work. Unfortunately, I don't have a replacement microcontroller right now, so this circuit can't be repaired at the moment. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.